Hello again, everyone. It's Mr. Hoy. I'm going to be factoring another set of trinomials. Both of these trinomials have an a value of 1. You want to pay attention to that when you're starting to do this because I'm going to show you kind of the shortcut method of factoring. Next week, we'll cover the AC method, which is a little bit more time-consuming. We're going to focus primarily this week just on factoring when you have an a value or this Lie coefficient of positive 1. As I mentioned in the last video, you want to set up your parentheses here first. If you have an x value there, put it here, and then you're focusing primarily on that last number, that c value, and you're trying to think of factors of that number that add up to the middle term, that negative 2. So I want to list factors of negative 15 that add up to negative 2. Let's list those factors now. You could have negative 1 and positive 15. You could have negative 15 and positive 1. You could have positive 3 and negative 5. Or you could have negative 3 and positive 5. Any of those sets will work. What you want to focus on when deciding between the two is, again, whether they add to that middle term there, that b value. So looking at these two, they add to positive 14. These will add to negative 14. This here will add to negative 2. This last set will add to a positive 2. So we want to take these two terms, the positive 3 we can put right here, and the negative 5 we can put there. And always check this work by distributing between the two. We would have x squared minus 5x plus 3x minus 15. And then when combining those two middle terms, the negative 5x and the 3x, we'll get back to where we started here at negative 2x. So that is the factored version of the first trinomial. Now, if you look at the second trinomial, we could steal these factors from the first question and use them again because we have the same c value. So again, we want to set up the two sets of parentheses. We'll put our x's here and here. But now we're looking for the factors to add up to a positive 2. So we can go over here and look at this set of factors. We have negative 3 and positive 5. We add the negative 3 to the positive 5, and we would get positive 2. So you can go ahead and put those factors here. Notice they're very similar questions, except for that middle term, that b value is negative 2 here, whereas positive 2 there. That leads to factors of negative 5 and positive 3 here, and negative 3, positive 5 there.